Good morning. Our story today is about being able to see the big picture. That's what it's about. And because most of you know how much I love Disney, I have a way that this connects, because all connects to Disney. I have a way for this to connect. Now, it's cool for those of you who have not seen the movie Up. How many of you have seen the movie Up? Yeah, it's a good movie. It's a good movie. And Douglas, one of the main characters in there, says a line that really connects to Joseph today. He says, I may not have gone where I intended to go, but I think I have ended up where I needed to be. Now think about that for a second. All of us, at some point, have started out, even if we're going out on a bike ride one day, and we get a little lost going around the neighborhood, and then we end up seeing something beautiful, a beautiful garden, or we meet one of our friends. It might not have been the trip we wanted to go on, but we ended up someplace wonderful. And that's what Joseph's saying in his story today. We didn't, like Harriet alluded to, we didn't hear all the scriptures leading up to it. Last week we were where Joseph, his brothers, were very green-eyed monsters and had thrown him into the pit and sold him off to slavery. And then we kind of skip ahead through all of what happens to where we get to today, where he meets up with his brothers. But along the way, Joseph started out as a shepherd. Then he became a slave. Then he was a prisoner. Then he was promoted to be second in command, and then he was back with his brothers. And he says, through all of that, God was with me. God had a plan of where I should be, but I didn't quite see it. And I brought a little demonstration today for us to try out. So if I show you this picture, from this spot that I'm showing you, what do you think's happening in this picture? Can you tell what's happening? Do you have an idea? Happy, sad, people, animals, any thoughts? Kind of hard to tell, isn't it? Because the spot that we're seeing is only that one little spot, so we don't really know exactly what's happening. What if I widen it a little bit more? What do you see now? It maybe looks like the moon. What else? Do you see anything else that you have an idea? People? Do you see some people? You're starting to see a little bit more. And if I widen it a little bit more, just a little bit more, do you get a better idea? Do you get any better idea? It kind of does, doesn't it? You get a little bit more. So that's the idea of our story. Sometimes we only get a view that's this big of what's happening, what God's going to do in our life. And the rest of it has to be the trust. This is the trust area. And Joseph had to trust that God was sending him where he wanted to go, that he would eventually end up with his brothers and the chance to share in that forgiveness. And do you know what the great thing about forgiveness is? Is forgiveness just good for the person who's getting forgiven? Like, Caitlin punched me, and I said, Caitlin, that's all right, I forgive you. Now, Caitlin feels good, but guess what? Do you think I feel good too?
No.
I do. I feel good because, not when I got punched, but I feel good. Because Caitlin's kind of a meanie, you know. But when Caitlin, I also felt good. Did you hear in the scripture that Joseph wept with each of his brothers? Because not only did the brothers feel better, he felt better too, because that's a pretty heavy burden to be mad all the time. That every time I would see Caitlin, I'd have to then remember again, oh right, I'm not talking to Caitlin, I'm mad because she punched me. That's a heavy burden to carry. Joseph saw the big picture, saw what God had planned for him and all the good he did in all of those ways, and he forgave his brothers, and he felt just as good as his brothers did. So I have a little something for you today that I want you to take with, to remember that In our lives, we're going to have to forgive a lot. There's going to be a lot of things that happen where we have to forgive somebody. And we may say one day, you know, I think, have you forgiven Tiara enough? You can't forgive her anymore. No, you can't say that. Because you know what's going to happen, especially as sisters? You're going to hurt each other's feelings along the way. And it's probably going to happen again next week. So I brought you a little something to remember, that forgiving is not a one-time thing. It says, forgive and then forgive some more. So it's over and over and over, because guess who's given us that example of forgiveness? Who has given us that example of forgiveness? God has given us that example of forgiveness. Because God forgives us over and over and over and loves us no matter what. Let's pray. Dear God, help us to trust you, because we don't always see the big picture. Joseph trusted you as he went from shepherd to slave to prisoner to second in command to back to the circle of being able to forgive with his brothers. You are a God of love, and you teach us that forgiveness is what we must do over and over, because it is good for us. Amen.